afternoon, everyone, or good morning or evening, depending on where you are in the world. I am Ruby Longstocking, and I'm here with Holden Kilfield, and you're watching the Miami Valley Open live from the Dayton Convention Center of Dayton, Ohio, brought to you by Gym City Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association Broadcasting. In the next game, this is game seven, we're going to see Gym City's Purple Rain taking on Royal City Roller Derby's Rootleggers. Purple Rain is, of course, from Dayton, and Royal City is from Guelph, Ontario. On Saturday, there was an exciting matchup between Purple Rain and Penn Jersey, and Purple Rain picked a win on that one. And Royal City fought hard, but took a loss to Vet City on Saturday as well. And so now we're going to turn to some rosters. So why don't you read a first roster for us, Gil?
Yes. So the first roster I'll be reading is Gem City Roller Derby's Purple Rain. We have 06, Wayne's Pearl, 10, Supersonic, 101, Tear a Hole in You, 111, Slamwise Gam G, 12, Via, 1209, Atkins, 1776, Busty St. Clair, 182, Danger, 23, Beast Mode, 27, Shredder, 311, Tripsy Hazard, 314, Pound Cake, 33, Glitch, 330, Stonewall Riot, 34, Minted Damsel, 697, Archangel Anarchy, 701, Dakota Dynamite, 84, Lexical Dexterity, 9, Outer Spacey, 909, Cheyenne Bean. And their coaches are Chris F., B. Naughty, Via King, and Pound Cake.
Love
Those
it.
Those are fun names.
Yeah, great. And I'll tell you who's skating for the Rootleggers today. It'll be 084 Scream, 1031 Pulp Vixen, 107 Rottweiler, 11 Artuso, 187 Morrison, 2 Smurfalicious, 2112 Electrocutioner, 23 Flying Frenchie, 24 Animal, 303 Spinderella, 31 Destroyer, 44 Princess Punch, 5 Slamoiselle, 57 Tragic Pyrene, 639 Praying Mantis, 686 Freddy, 8008 Gorshak, 89 Built Ford Ruff, and 94 Femka Fatale. I do not have their coaches, but I will throw it back to you, Kill, so that you can tell us who is officiating. Bless their hearts, the officiating crew. Want to give them a recognition?
Yes. Thank you so much for volunteering your time. The skating officials for this game with our head ref is Strong Female Character. We also have Bitty Bobbity Boom, Ella Noise, M-O-S or Moss, not sure how to pronounce, David Feckham, Elke Hollick, Noah Fallon, Freddie Mercury Poisoning. And our non-skating officials are Mary Choppins, Dorothy Gale Force, Dread Hockey Lee, Kilsey Grammer, Galvatron, Stabby McNeedles, Bubbles Dace Marie, Kitty Stardust, and Mimi First. Again, wonderful names, everyone. Wonderful names.
Yeah. Great job on the names. We love it. We hope that stay here for the next two games with us on Twitch. I'm sorry I interrupted you, Kill. What were you going to say?
Oh, yeah, no, not a problem. I think that's why we all enjoy watching Derby, not only for the athleticism, but also with the creativity of the names.
Yes. There are some good ones. So just to give you a little bit of information about this particular tournament, this is the first ever tournament that Gem City has put on. Gem City was founded in Dayton since 2006. And they will be hosting an open recruitment day on May 28th. So if you are in that area and you are interested in doing some of this great work, see an enormous army of volunteers here on the track helping us get this tournament done. And we need all kinds of people. So make sure that you stop by if you're in the area. If not, you can go to gymcityrollerderby.com and find out more about their league.
So we are starting up with this lineup. I'm interested to see who is fighting for the front, who is fighting for the back. And so here we are.
It is. It looks like everyone's close to the jam line for this start. They may change their minds. Supersonic, it will be taking on Artuso off the jammer line. Wow, a very fast pickup there by Supersonic, lead jammer for Purple Rain. Artuso also out of the pack, both jammers eligible for scoring. Supersonic slows down as approaches the pack. Does a little spin move. We'll see how many hips. Actually, one point apiece. So it's a little sneaky 1 point for the bootleggers. But we are at a tie game.
And those 1 points can make or break a game. So let's see how many more points each team can end up acquiring. Right now, we are setting up. We are having bootleggers doing a nice formation at the front of the pack. We are seeing a Purple Rain pivot going to play some O for their jammer, who is Danger. It is Princess Punch, actually, from Bootleggers, who ends up receiving lead with Danger still stuck behind. They end up finding an opening on the outside line, rushing off a block. And they are coming around. We have Princess Punch looking for a couple of openings for some points. Ends up getting knocked out at the top of the apex of turn one, calls it off before Danger is even able to receive any points. And Bootleggers is awarded 2 points for that jam. So this is going to be a point for point game so far.
Yeah. Extra style points goes to that jammer for calling it off on the knee slide. Lovely.
And correction, was given 3 points at that jam.
Right, they do like to slip in that one last point before the next jam. Now we have Shredder taking on Smurfalicious off the jam line. Shredder's up at the front of the pack, but Bootleggers really able to reform in front of the jammer there. Smurfalicious working against the Purple Rain defenders at the back of the pack. That pack is getting spread out. Having to have a couple of bridges here. But this is just a slog right now. Jammer's just pushing against the defense. That is Smurfalicious driven into the infield. There will be a penalty awarded for that effort. But the pack does get stretched out so far that Shredder is able to pull out lead jammer for Purple Rain. Murphalicious is still looking to get out on the initial pass. Meanwhile, Shredder picks up the full four. Oh, nice little run up the inside lane there around turn number two. Shredder now with 8. Smurfalicious just struggling with that Purple Rain defense. Those of you watching, the penalty box is right here at the bottom right hand of your screen. So if you see bodies flying in another there, they're right underneath the WFTDA logo. And that puts us 12 points on that run for Purple Rain. That's 13 for them and 4 for the Bootleggers.
Wow, Purple Rain really ran away with that last jam. We are lining up. Purple Rain is looking to try to take advantage and take the front of the pack. It looks like they are down one blocker. As we see Bootleggers trying to defend Supersonic. Supersonic is fighting against that tripod, and it is Spinderella, who looks like they tried to find an opening on the outside, wasn't able to get it, was denied, drawn back. They come running on up, but it is Purple Rain who is giving them a fight for their derby life, and Purple Rain Supersonic is the one that ends up receiving the lead. Spinderella is still stuck behind, trying to find an opening, finds an opening on that inside line on the opposite side of the track, is running around trying to hurry up and catch up before Supersonic is able to call it off. Supersonic ends up receiving another 4 points. They are trailing behind Spinderella. Spinderella approaches the pack, ends up getting knocked out by a blocker. They are dragging Spinderella all the way back, has to re-engage with the pack. And it is Spinderella who ends up receiving a point because a Purple Rain blocker ended up falling down. We see Supersonic fighting against a two-wall Brutelegger, gets right through at the top of the apex, ends up receiving another 4 points. Spinderella is struggling a little bit behind this strong purple wall, trying to find an opening, but still stuck on the opposite side of the track. While Supersonic is just finding those points, ends up getting another 4 points and calls it off before Spinderella is able to get a full 4 points. That is 12 points, Purple Rain, and Spinderella ends up receiving 2 points for their jamming effort.
Make sure you visit gymcityrollerderby.com for Gym City merch. As we head into jam number 5, Danger taking on Artuso off the jammer line. Danger is now contending with the tripod of Brutleggers. Artuso with a tripod of purple here too. When the defense has a chance to set up, it is just absolutely stopping the jammers. Artuso looking for that outside lane does get closed off. Danger at the front of the pack, pushing against that one last blocker. And that is super important, that one-on-one defense. But it is Artuso that gets out of the pack first, is lead. Now Danger is back, engaging with that defense, still on the initial pass. Artuso now looking for a scoring pass, but again, that tripod of purple shirts is just hanging on. Nice spin move there, another spin move, but man, the Purple Rain is able to just keep cycling those blockers right in front of the jammer, but Artuso does finally get out of the pack for 4. Danger, meanwhile, getting recycled back between the pivot and jammer lines. Heard some whistles there. We'll see a blocker go to the box. That loosens up the Purple Rain defense a little bit, but Artuso unable to take full advantage of it, but there will be a blocker headed to the penalty box for that. Meanwhile, Danger also being recycled now. That's 4 additional points for Artuso as Artuso gets out of the pack. And that jam will come to its conclusion. 12 points total put up for the Brutleggers. That brings them to 18 to Purple Rain's 25. And we're ticking down to about 22 minutes left in the first half.
We're definitely seeing both sides being able to receive large points during a jam. So this could be a big battle between how many each of the teams are able to get those points. We saw Purple Rain end up receiving 12 points a couple of jams ago. And for this jam, we are seeing a pack disadvantage for Purple Rain. On that jammer line, it is Supersonic for Purple Rain. Even though they had a disadvantage, Supersonic ends up getting lead with Prentice Punched fighting against a Purple Rain tripod. Supersonic is approaching the Brutelegger's tripod, comes through, hoops to the outside, fakes him out, comes to the inside, finds an opening, ends up receiving 4 points. Prentice Punch is still trying to find an opening, trying to find a way to get some points for their team. And it is the Purple Rain tripod. They are doing really great track awareness while Supersonic is just skating around all of the blockers and receiving another 4 points. Prentice Punch ends up finding an opening, and it is a hit from 101 from Purple Rain, but Prentice Punch is able to just brush that right off, ends up receiving no points. They aren't lead. That was their first initial pass. Before they're able to even receive any points, Purple Rain's blocker and jammer ends up calling that off, and that is 12 points that was received by Purple Rain's jammer. So once more, this could be a 12 to 12, yeah. 8 to 8, 1 to 1. They are competing for these points.
Yeah, I was just noticing we're swapping off jams here. Got some love in the Twitch chat for Slamwise Ganji, Rain, and Shredder. Talk to us in the chat if you have a question or would like to give a shout out to your favorite player. Meanwhile, Shredder, as we just mentioned, for Purple Rain, is out as lead jammer. Smurfalicious is wearing the star for Bootleggers. At the very front of the pack, only one blocker to beat. Just going to tiptoe it out. Just going to tiptoe it out. Works. So they'll get the 4 points there for Purple Rain. Call off that jam. That does bring Purple Rain to 41. Bootlegger sit at 18. And we're about 19 minutes, 44 seconds left in the half.
That was a very short jam. So this may be a strategy from Purple Rain to try to get a couple of points and call it off before Bootleggers is even able to get a scoring pass. Right now, 5 seconds has been called. It is both teams are at one blocker down. They are in the penalty box. We have Archangel Anarchy for Purple Rain versus Spinderella for Bootleggers. It is a bit of a scrum. They are both fighting between those packs, but it looks like it is going to be Archangel Anarchy fighting around that apex to get out right before Spinderella, who is about 20 feet behind them. They are racing around, trying to find some points, and once more, both sides are losing another blocker. We have Archangel hurrying up, hitting against that strong white wall, and it is called off. Not sure if any points have been awarded. Looking at the ref, can't really tell, but we'll check over here. Yes, 4 points awarded for Purple Rain. Bootleggers ended up receiving 3 points.
Wow.
That was a fight. That was a fight.
It was a fight. It was. That was very determined folks there. But again, we have a very even matchup, 4-3 on that jam. So now you're looking at Supersonic taking our 2-0. And it is Supersonic spinning, that manages to get out of the pack first, pick up lead jammer. Artuzo running against that last blocker. Wow, everybody goes out of bounds. Just everyone. So Artuzo is able to cut back onto the track in front of that blocker. And that jam will be called. Yeah, I think you might be right, Kill. This may be a strategy here. 3 points for Purple Rain. That brings them to 48. Bootlegger sit at 21, and we're at 17:40.
Yes, and so for this next jam, we have Purple Rain with their full four blockers, while Bootleggers is at a disadvantage. Oh, wait, looks like one blocker has come on the track a little late. They are still down one blocker. It is advantage for Purple Rain. 5 seconds has been called, and we have both of the jammers evenly lined up and attacking both of those tripods. They're being stuck behind, and it is Shredder for Purple Rain who ends up falling, quickly gets up, and is pushing that white wall, trying to push them out of play, ends up finding an opening at the top of the apex. Princess Punch for Bootleggers is still stuck behind and is received a penalty. It is a power jam for Purple Rain. Purple Rain, we have Shredder coming up with a little bit of O from their blocker. They get knocked out at the top of the apex around turns two. They are trying to find another opening, trying to push them out. Looks like their blockers are doing the strategy of just staying rather than allowing an O to create a pack. And we heard somebody from Purple Rain's bench say call it right away. So it looks like they want to end up having a starting jam, a power jam start.
They ice the, we can't see the penalty box, but I'm not sure the jammer would have been standing. Not sure we have quite that much time, but we'll see. It does give Purple Rain an opportunity to look fresh eyes at the pack, and wow, Supersonic saw that lane and just took it.
Yes,
fast. So there's the jammer standing, right. And there comes Princess Punch. Purple Rain has already set up in preparation for Princess Punch. Supersonic's now working at the front of the pack, pushing blockers forward. And it does look like that maybe was an out of play call there, but Supersonic picks up the four. Now got to come in for another scoring pass. Oh, and Princess Punch with another penalty there. So that's two on Princess Punch in a row. So this is a power jam again for Supersonic and the Purple Rain. Supersonic on the toe stops on the outside. Does make it through for an additional 412 so far on the board for Supersonic. You can see the team setting up for offense there. Supersonic almost makes it, but decides to call it off. But it was the jammer. Princess Punch was released right at the very end there. So we will start with two jammers on this next jam. Purple Rain got 16 on that run. That brings them to 67. Bootlegger sit at 21.
And this isn't a flyaway game just yet. We still have 14 minutes left in the first half. Right now, both sides are evenly matched with all four blockers on both sides. We also are seeing that the jammers are lining up on the same side, closer to the outside of the track. The whistle is blown. A little hesitation. Not sure if they weren't sure if that was their whistle. But we do have Danger just doing a nice little spin move right at the top, 10 feet away from the jammer line. Ends up receiving lead. It is Smurfalicious for Bootleggers. Still stuck behind a really strong tripod. And Danger ends up approaching, using force, trying to push out the white wall. Ends up being slipping on the ground, but only has one blocker from Bootleggers left before they end up getting out at the top of the apex, receiving 4 points for that effort. Bootleggers are holding back. Purple Rain is holding back Smurfalicious. Smurfalicious was knocked out at the top of the apex. Still trying to find an opening, and we end up having Bootlegger blocker coming in, looking to try to play some O. But before that can happen, Purple Rain ends up calling it, and that is 8 points for Purple Rain, Bootlegger zero.
Timeout.
Official review.
Oh, official my goodness.
Review. So what did we not see?
So many things.
What did we not catch from that last jam? That's a very interesting. I'm interested to knowing what would the official review be.
I'm not sure. I am honestly not sure. There are definitely having the conversation there, an explanation, it looks like.
I like how Riot Raya, go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead. No, you.
I was saying from the Twitch chat, I like how Riot Raya, or is it Raya Rhea? They said, I like how quickly the tides can turn in roller derby. And isn't that the truth? Look at the score.
It's
we
so
have
75
true. Purple Rain versus Bootleggers 21, as well as an official review. Didn't see that coming. Didn't see it from our vantage point. And that's why it's always great to at least try to see some derby in person. But being able to watch it online is just as nice.
That's amazing. And if you would like to broadcast your games without the expense and hassle of traditional streaming, the Remote Studio can get your games to a global audience with as little as a smartphone. No matter your location or budget, get streaming with the Remote Studio. Contact broadcast at quadmedia.tv and check out our broadcasting for beginners resources at wftda.tv.
I've been enjoying the streaming because I've been able to watch a lot of derby from teams that I've never would ever have known about or heard about unless we were able to do the online streaming.
Yes. And the benefit is that you can watch these later on YouTube and you can watch them with your teammates and pick up on some things.
Absolutely. We are making memories last forever, aren't we?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, it looks like the official review, yeah.
I'm not gonna speculate. I don't know.
I was just saying, I think we're done with the official review.
Yes.
Skated away from your bench. And it looks like we're about to resume some derby.
Yeah, we don't see the scoreboard change at all. So
And I honestly don't remember how many blockers were on the track at the end of that last jam. So again, we aren't able to speculate if it is a blocker penalty or a jammer penalty, or we just don't know. So if you happen to know and you want to send it to us in the Twitch, that'll be wonderful.
Basher 49, we also enjoy being able to watch your people in Ohio. All right, so that rolling whistle means we're getting ready to head into the next jam. If we do find out any information about this official review, we'll let you know, but we're not always able to find that out. But it does look like it was lost, so we know that it was not successful. Shredder has got on the star for Purple Rain. Spinderella is wearing the star for Bootleggers, but it's Shredder out of the pack first. Picks up lead jammer. Blocker exiting the penalty box waits just a second for Shredder, but Shredder is very, very fast. Spinderella does get out of the pack on the initial, so that'll doesn't want to cause it, but it does sort of cause the call off for Purple Rain. But 4 points on the board for Purple Rain there. That brings them to 79. Bootleggers sit at 21.
And right now, for this next jam, we have it where bootleggers are at advantage with all four blockers. Purple Rain down one blocker. We are seeing bootleggers doing a strategy of trying to swarm at the top of the pack. Both jammers have engaged, and it's looking like it's going to be Artuso who ends up getting lead, finding that opening right on the outside line. Supersonic ends up finding an opening later at the top of the apex, and is Artuso approaching? Jumps that apex. Let's see. Did they get the points? Let's see. It looks like I see some numbers raised. They ended up receiving 4 points. They jumped that apex, so they did land
Wow.
before they fell. And they received 4 points, denying Purple Rain any points for that jam.
Nicely done. And I
And they just
like how
approached so
often.
calmly.
Landed, and again, a call off from the floor. Got to give him style points. Now, Princess Punch. Now contending with this tripod, just pushing like a sled. We're just going to push the whole tripod forward. Meanwhile, Danger working against the tripod of bootleggers at the front of the pack. Bootleggers get spread out a little bit here as they're having to bridge. They're going to have to let Danger go. Danger does pick up lead jammer status. Now we see a swarm of bodies descending upon all those purple shirts trying to get Princess Punch out. But now they have to settle down and reform because here comes Danger. And now we're back at the stop, the very slow. Oh, nice little offensive work there. Cannot read that blocker's jersey, but trying to open up that tripod. But boy, they are just locked down. Danger, one blocker to beat, does finally get out of the pack. I feel my legs are sore from that, and I'm not even on the track. That's 4 points for Danger. Danger had to take a slow lap around there just to think about how to approach that tripod again. Meanwhile, Princess Punch, I think that was a star stash, not a star pass, gets out of the pack. But no points on the board for the bootleggers, but four more picked up for Purple Rain. That brings them to 83. Bootleggers at 25.
With a little less than 9 minutes, 9.5 minutes left for period one, we are seeing that Purple Rain is about to take away with this at 83 points versus Bootleggers 25. Both are lined up on the track. It's looking like, yes, all four blockers are on the track. We're seeing a strong wall, but we are seeing Bootlegger Smurfalicious trying to push them through, but it is Shredder who ends up finding that opening, ends up receiving lead. Smurfalicious is still stuck behind Purple Rain, slowly trying to find openings as Shredder is approaching, is denied trying to find an opening on the inside line. They too are also trying to weave back and forth, doing little lateral movement while Smurfalicious is knocked out at the top of Apex turn one. Both jammers are pushing against strong walls, just trying to grind and push them. And they are within 10 feet of each other. And it is actually Smurfalicious who does find an opening at the top of the Apex, doing a little fake out, jumping out to the outside line, jumping back to the inside. And before they are even able to get any points, Purple Rain ends up calling it. That is a 0-0. Let's see. Want to make sure. Oh, no. That is 3 points for Purple Rain and 0 points for Bootleggers. It's a little hard to see the fingers. Can't really distinguish them from this angle.
It is. They're very, very tiny fingers from this balcony view. It's nice to see the whole track, though. We are headed into jam number 17. Supersonic taking on Spinderella. It is Supersonic up that inside lane. Does pick up lead jammer for Purple Rain. Spinderella has to be recycled a bit. Lots of players in there trying to run some interference for Spinderella, and it works. Spinderella is out on the initial pass, but here comes Supersonic out for the scoring pass. Picks up the full four. And we'll call that off before the Bootleggers can put any points on the board, I believe. That brings Purple Rain to 90. Bootleggers sit at 25.
And we are having a team timeout from Purple Rain. Team timeout called by Purple Rain. I think that's really smart. Give your team a little breather. Discuss a little bit more strategy, but right now we are seeing that Purple Rain is icing out Bootleggers 90-25. So if they're going to continuously fight for lead jammer, I think we can say confidently that they will continuously try to call off the jam the moment that the other team ends up getting out before they can get points. So these may be shorter jams. What do you think?
I think that you're probably correct there, unless they can get a good solid get a jammer hung up in the defense for multiple laps. I think you're right. They'll jump out, pick up a couple of points, call it, and go for multiple jams.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, we are lining up. We are seeing both sides trying to decide where we should line up. Purple Rain is at pack advantage, and we are seeing blocker number 1209 for Purple Rain setting themselves up so they can go ahead and play some O. 5 seconds has been called. Both jammers are neck and neck, side by side, and we have Artuso fighting against that strong purple wall, as well as Danger fighting against that strong white wall, ends up finding openings, pushing them out as well. And there is a no pack called, which allows Danger to receive lead easily. Artuso still stuck behind in that scrum little park, whereas at the Apex, they are trying to find an opening, slipping and sliding a little bit, immediately regaining control and pushing against that wall. Danger finds an opening and just easily gets out. Does a little spin move and receives 4 points. Artuso still fighting against that wall. Gets knocked out. We are seeing that a blocker, purple blocker, ends up falling on Artuso. Artuso is holding their cheek. They're fine. Everybody gets up. That is a penalty assessed to the purple blocker. And Artuso finally ends up getting out. It is called before she is able to receive any points. And that is the end of that jam. That is 6 points gained by Purple Rain versus Bootleggers 0.
That was crazy.
Yes. This is a very intense game. Yeah, it is a very intense game.
Seeing a lot of spin moves out there. I really love it. So Princess Punch back on the line for Bootlegger. Supersonic taking the star for Purple Rain. It is Supersonic out of the pack first. Princess Punch at the front of the pack there, way at the top of your screen. Just a couple more blockers to contend with and does get out of the pack on the initial. Meanwhile, Supersonic is back at the pack looking for scoring and decides to call it off. So there you go, Kill. That's your strategy coming to pass here. 4 points picked up by Purple Rain. That'll bring them to an even 100 points. Bootleggers sit at 25.
Wow. All right, let's see what we have in store for this next jam. We are at pack advantage for Bootleggers as Purple Rain blockers are forming at the top of the pack. 5 seconds has been called. Both jammers are looking and staring down at the blocker wall. Both end up engaging both walls. And it is Smurfalicious who is pushing the purple wall all the way up. But it is Shredder who ends up finding an opening. They are denied by a white blocker who is also playing O and D simultaneously, trying to find that opening. That is white pivot. Once I get that number, I'm going to give you a shout out. Really great track awareness. It is Purple Rain Shredder who ends up receiving lead. Smurfalicious is still stuck behind, and we have the Bootlegger pivot ends up receiving a penalty. They are going to the penalty box while Shredder is approaching, looking to score 4 points. Smurfalicious is still stuck behind, and they are trying to find an opening, slowly inching a couple of inches and feet, trying to find the opening while Shredder ends up going around the pack, finds that lovely lane on the outside line and calls it. That is Purple Rain ends up receiving 4 points. That was a hard fought 4 points versus Bootlegger 0.
I feel like they have earned every single one of those 104 points.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. A lot of work out there. Okay, so jammers lining up on the jam line, and it looks like all of the interesting play there for Purple Rain. They had split up the pack so they could sort of collapse onto the defense of the Bootleggers. And it worked this time. Danger out of the pack first, wearing the star for Purple Rain. Spinderella has got the star on for the Bootleggers. Getting a little bit of a recycle here, back into turn one. Almost to the pivot line, not quite. Danger gets bumped out on the far straightaway. And we get the very definitive call off from the bench. Call it. So that is what happens. 3 points will be added to Purple Rain. Brings them to 107 to Bootleggers 25. We're right at 3 minutes left in this half.
Purple Rain is definitely iced out. Bootleggers. Bootleggers has been at 25 points for a few jams now. We are now starting jam number 21. And both jammers are looking to try to find that opening. It looks like Supersonic was favoring that inside line, ends up being denied, going out and finds an opening on the outside line before entering the apex, while Artuso finds that opening on the inside line and is following right behind. Supersonic speeding up, trying to find some points while their blockers are trying to line up. And we hear a call it before Bootleggers is even able to get any points. Let's see how many points Purple Rain has received. That is 3 for that jam, 110 versus 25.
We did mention this earlier, but all of these games are published on YouTube a few days after the game. If you're watching on YouTube, those of you, please hit that thumbs up button. Let us know you like the show. It really helps us. It really helps out the channel and helps us to keep bringing you these wonderful tournaments. Shredder taking on Princess Punch off the jam line. It is Princess Punch that has earned lead jammer for the Bootleggers. And I do not have a production sheet, but I think that is the first lead jammer they've had in quite some time. Two blockers at the front, and they do bump her out. Oh, such a recycle. Oh, all the way back to the pivot line. Now we have to go through that whole wall again. No one is moving here. We are locked down at turn two. Just a big slog. So we do have a little interference being run by the pivot of the Bootleggers, but it is Shredder. No, that is not lead. That's right, because Bootleggers already had lead. Sorry, I got so excited about all of that defense that I forgot that Bootleggers already had lead. So it doesn't look like any points were put on the board there for either team. So we're still sitting at 110 to 25.
Again, this score is not indicative of what we're seeing because the bootleggers are
Wow.
giving Purple Rain. They are giving their jammers a hard time. Those jammers are fighting for some of these points. And so
Yes.
5 seconds has been called. We are seeing 1209 for Purple Rain trying to play some O for Supersonic. Supersonic ends up receiving lead while Bootlegger Smurfalicious is stuck behind, but quickly finds that opening on the inside and hurries up out so they can try to find some points for their team. Supersonic ends up fighting, just juking from the inside to the outside. And before they are able to fully leave the pack, their bench tells them to call it. They end up receiving 4 points, and that is intermission. Bootleggers ends up receiving zero. That was nice.
Wow. I feel
Yes.
like your point was so well made. Like, yes, there's a large score spread here, but a point spread here, but every point has been earned. It has been that's not indicative of what we're seeing on the track. Just incredible defense and lots of track awareness out there, both teams.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to try to find, like I had mentioned, there was a really good blocker from Bootleggers who ended up playing defense, held the jammer, then ran up, played some O, and then came back. And I could not see your number. So this is just a shout out to all of the blockers from both sides. You're doing an amazing job. This is going so fast. And it's I'm trying to find your number and try to find your name while I'm still trying to commentate. It's very hard. But just want to say we recognize the work that the blockers are doing just as well. And so it's a team
Yes,
effort.
absolutely. So you'll definitely want to come back after the halftime so that you can see the rest of this game. Welcome back, everybody. Glad to see you back on Twitch. You are watching Purple Rain taking on the Bootleggers. And over our intermission, we got a chance to take a look at some data. So it looks like we only have one blocker in any kind of penalty trouble. Is that correct, Kill?
Yes, that's blocker for Bootleggers. That is Morrison, number 187. They currently have 5 penalties. And let's see. Yes. And they have the C, so they are captain for their team. So Royal City Bootleggers, 187. Morrison has 5 penalties right now. Everyone else is, two, three. There is another blocker that has 4 penalties, number 639 from White Bootleggers. And on the Purple Rain side, it's been fairly okay. 3 penalties most for a couple of blockers.
I love it. I love the emojis. So thanks. So what we have seen out there is some incredible defense, and I think both Kill and I over the break were like, we wish we could see all these numbers of all these people and make sure to give them a shout out. So if you're in the Twitch chat and you would like to shout out a blocker that we can't see their number, we would love to be able to give them a shout out because man, they're doing some incredible work out there.
Agreed. Agreed. So we always see the jammers. It's easy to see that jammer, and the jammers are working very hard. But those jammers' success is also because of their blockers. And so
Yes.
please say thank you. Shout out to the blockers as well.
Blockers. Yay.
I'm a blocker.
Yeah. High five, high five. There you go. It is. Lovely. All right, so it does look like everybody is lining up here, getting ready to head into the second half of this game. So this is not the last game of the Miami Valley Open Tournament. There is one more game after this. So you'll want to make sure to stay on Twitch for the re remainder of this game and then the next game as well. It looks like we are going to have. Is that correct or is that from the previous one? I'll wait till the jam starts here. There we go. That is Supersonic taking on Artuzo, sorry. Artuzo thought that inside lane was going to be open but got rejected. Meanwhile, Supersonic looking for the outside, being recycled back to the pivot line. Artuzo at the front of the pack again, just pushing against that tripod. does escape that one blocker that stepped out of bounds, but now everybody's reformed back in front of Artuso. Not getting spread out a little bit as Artuso is pushing against the front. Whew. Meanwhile, at the back, Supersonic experiencing the pressure of the tripod. Now, we didn't see a... So did you see a no pass, no penalty there, Kill?
I did not see that.
Oh. So they're declaring Supersonic as the lead there. I wonder what happened there to not allow the Bootleggers to get lead. But okay, now we have, there are two leads apparently.
This is when we insert the oh. This is when we can insert the oh, because that's incorrect, y'all.
I was like, I know I was confused, but my goodness.
All right, we will figure that out. Right now, we are starting with the next jam. Both jammers are attacking a tripod. We are having Purple Rain at the back while Bootleggers are in the front. It is Shredder for Purple Rain versus Bootleggers Princess Punch. And it is a power jam for Bootleggers. Bootleggers, we are seeing Princess Punch fight against a two wall, push them out. It is out of play, and they end up receiving lead. Bootleggers Princess Punch ends up receiving lead. It is a power jam with another blocker from Purple Rain going to the penalty box, and Princess Punch tries to find the opening on the outside, slides out, ends up having a blocker fall down, and is able to receive those 4 points. This is a wonderful opportunity for Bootleggers. They needed this power jam, and they are taking advantage of it. We see Shredder coming out of the penalty box, immediately getting released. They are not lead. They are coming around for another swarm pass. We'll see if Bootleggers ends up calling it or allowing it to run. We hear from the bench that they wanted Bootleggers to call it. It is called, and that was 8 points for Bootleggers versus Purple Rain, 0. It is a timeout, and a timeout is being called for, let's see, I can't really see the benches. It's a bench somewhere from the right side off the screen. Who called it? Purple Rain. Purple Rain has called the team timeout. Yes. Was waiting for the blinking light for the scoreboard. So we are having a team timeout.
It's such a tiny blinking light. It's such a very tiny blinking light.
So that was, like I said, a much needed power jam for Bootleggers, as they were at 25 points for the remainder, a good half of period one until the end, and as we entered into intermission. So receiving 10 more points, really great job, Bootleggers. Yes.
The WFTDA is pleased to announce that the WFTDA game sanctioning will resume in 2023. We're implementing a new competitive system based on geographical regions that focuses on recovery and sustainability. We've also adjusted the WFTA rankings algorithm to promote more gameplay by enabling teams to compete against a wider variety of opponents. To learn more, visit community.wftda.org. We are headed into jam number 3. Gem City's Purple Rain, of course, wearing the blue jerseys, and that's Danger with a star. We'll pick up lead jammer. Bootleggers in white, Smurfalicious around the outside, but gets, knocked out there by two blockers. One of those blockers does stay in bounds. Nope, apparently not. I am not on the track, so I cannot say. But Danger, meanwhile, has picked up 4 points for Purple Rain. Lots of whistles here. You know, lots of folks coming in and out of the penalty box. The penalty box is right below the WFTDA logo. They're both jammers out of the pack, so that will be called. 8 points on the board for Purple Rain brings them to 122. Bootleggers sit at 35.
Those of you that are watching, I'm interested if you can go ahead and respond in Twitch chat. What is your favorite floor? Right now, we are seeing that this is a little bit of coated concrete, but it's like it's a little slicker at the top of the apex. So let us know what is your favorite floor. I enjoy concrete, but also wood comes in second. Sport court, I cannot stand. But this floor is looking like it's a wonderful floor to come to. If you are coming from out of state, I always enjoy seeing concrete. It's a timeout, and we are looking like that timeout has been completed. 5 seconds has been called, and we are looking at a disadvantage to Purple Rain. They only have two blockers out, and Spinderella is looking for that opening. They are trying to find that opening on the outside, but they end up getting blacked up by another purple blocker. They found really great track around awareness, and it gives Spinderella ends up receiving lead, even though Supersonic ended up getting out earlier. Supersonic is coming around for a scoring pass. They end up receiving 4 points while Spinderella is finally on their first scoring pass, trying to find opening. They are looking on the outside at the top of the apex, are denied by that blocker, tries to find it again, is blocked by their own pivot accidentally, ends up finding an opening, looking around, and they find that opening, receiving 4 points. Supersonic, even though they are not lead, they have already gone on their second scoring pass, looking to do a third scoring pass, while Spinderella is closely behind them, looking for their second scoring pass. Supersonic is unopposed. They get out very quickly, ends up receiving 4 points easily. That is 12 points to Bootlegger's Spinderella. Spinderella is still stuck behind, ends up having the star cap fall off, immediately has to put it back on. And right now, Supersonic is being unopposed. Supersonic is just raking in these points, even though they aren't lead. Lead has been taken away from Spinderella. I believe it's because their helmet cover did fall off. Spinderella tried to call it off. They aren't lead anymore, so the jam has to go to its natural conclusion. Spinderella is still trying to find an opening, needs to get a couple of more points because right now Supersonic is at 20 points, approaching, looking for another 4 points. Spinderella is knocked out on the inside, on the other side of the track, slowly approaching the back of the pack, trying to find that opening while it is a strong purple four wall. Supersonic is fighting against that white wall, ends up receiving a couple of points, and the jam comes to its natural conclusion. That is unfortunate when the panty ends up falling off gently and lead was taken away. That is really unfortunate. Purple Rain ended up taking advantage of that jam, ends up receiving 24 points versus Brutlegger's 8. Wow.
Yeah, that was heartbreaking. I didn't see the whole entire thing from beginning, but I think she did remove it. Because
Oh,
going up against
okay.
that defense
Nice.
has been really hard.
Okay. I'm halfway looking at the other side of the track and then looking on there. I just saw it going back on ahead. Thanks for clarifying.
Sure. I mean, I think that is true. And hey, you can watch it on YouTube later, everybody, and make sure that that is the right call. But that is heartbreaking. As we're into jam number five here, Artuzo taking on Shredder. Shredder's already out of the pack on a scoring pass. Artuzo does make it out of the pack on the initial. Shredder's coming in for the second scoring pass and decides to call that off before Artuzo can put any points on the board. 5 points total for Purple Rain. That brings them to 151. Bootlegger sit at 43.
Right now, Brutlegger's has all of their team timeouts. We'll see if any of those are used for this second half. Purple Rain is coming in, looking to swarm at the top of the pack. They are both doing the same configuration of a tripod with floaters. Their floaters are the pivots, looking to place some O right off the line. Both jammers end up engaging, and it is Prentice Punch for Brutleggers with Purple Rain's Danger. Danger ends up getting out at the top of the apex with only one blocker to get past. They get out, and it is Prince's Punch pushed, like punched at the top of the apex on the inside line. They are being denied by those blockers. Those blockers from Purple Rain are giving Prince's Punch a lot of trouble right now. Danger effortlessly skips right through the white wall, ends up receiving 4 points, while we have Prince's Punch trying to fight against a two wall. No pack is called. One of the blockers has to go back to make sure that they are bridging, while Prince's Punch ends up getting out. Prince's Punch is coming around looking for some points, but is denied as Purple Rain's Danger ends up calling it. That is 7 points, Purple Rain versus Bootlegger 0. Wow. This is now getting, this is the stakes are raising right now.
Yeah, we're just seeing bodies fly all inside that pack of the hits are hard. They just knocking people about, not just the jammers, blockers are blocking blockers as well, throwing those bodies around. It is a tough track out there. Supersonic and Smurfalicious into that tough pack. Now Supersonic is at the front of the pack trying to rotate that gear and does. So that tripod collapses there. Supersonic picks up lead. Smurfalicious looking for a way through, but that just the way that spin of that tripod is just so flawless that it locks in Smurfalicious, unable to get out of that cog. Supersonic now does step on the line, so decides to recycle, but gets the motion from the bench to call it, so that will happen. 3 points on the board for Purple Rain. We're right at 20 minutes left in the second half.
And right at these 20 minutes left of second half, we are seeing that we are moving towards the pivot line. Ooh, I love a good pivot line setup. But before we can even start, a timeout has been called and it is being directed to, I'm not sure who. Oh, it's an official review. Purple Rain is asking for an official review. So,
Yes.
was it the last jam? Was it Bootlegger's Jammer who ended up calling out? You said they got knocked out.
At the very end, no, I was saying that. I'm sorry, I had to think of what did I say? Okay. I said, but the blockers were knocking each other out.
That, okay. I'm trying to understand what this again, just guessing what happened in the last jam. What happened for an official review to be called by Purple Rain?
I find it interesting that they asked for the call off and then immediately the official review. So it was almost as if, go ahead and call it so I can call the official review.
Yeah. Okay. Well, while we wait, what is your favorite floor? I already waxed poetically about mine, sport court. I can't stand it. But
I
this
don't, I'm
concrete
not a
looks
fan of
great.
sport court. Yeah, I'm not a fan of sport
Yes.
court. Not a fan. Would, I guess, would.
Yes, I love wood. I love a good wood floor. That is a really nice floor. We have in the Twitch, it shard core or Corey. Ends up saying Jim consistently has great zone coverage. I agree.
Yeah, yes, absolutely. All right, everybody is re going to the infield right now, so I guess this is going to be the official making the ruling. Unfortunately, I got nothing from those hand signals. I can't even begin to imagine.
Well, as that ruling has happened, we do see one of the bootlegger jammers coming up, having a discussion, pointing to their side. Again, that's all we can say to you. And we'll see when official review is completed. Okay, that's the end. Is it my turn or is it your turn? I can't remember what jam we're on now.
We'll be going into jam 8, so it's on you.
There we are. All right. And so jam 8 has begun, and we have Spinderella for Bootleggers versus Purple Rain Shredder. Again, a hard scrum. Those blockers are refusing to allow anybody out. And just as I said that, both jammers are looking to be out, and it is actually Purple Rain Shredder getting a penalty and a lead. Has been awarded to Bootleggers, Spinderella. Spinderella is coming around. This is a power jam for Bootleggers. Bootleggers is using one blocker to come up to play O while the remaining three does a little waterfall trying to sweep out those blockers. It is Not as successful, but the second time it's looking really successful as Spinderella is able to find multiple openings and is able to push the blockers up towards the jam line. Still, Spinderella is fighting against that two wall. That two wall is refusing to let Spinderella go. Finally, Spinderella spins around and ends up receiving 4 points. Still a power jam. We are having Bootleggers trying to set up, getting ready for the arrival of Shredder, who's been released. Spinderella spins around, and before Shredder can even get any points, Spinderella ends up calling it. That was 4 points for Bootleggers.
Oh, they just snuck in 3 more points. So 7 points total on that run.
Oh,
they do
yes,
that.
Yes. Before she did her little spin move and she called it off, she
yeah.
did go past those hips.
They sneak in those points right after you finished your score review. But now we have Danger taking on Artuzo from the jammer line. Oh, nice little work there. I cannot see the pivot's number, but nice work there, just scooping out the blocker, opening up the lane. Artuzo is able to pick up lead jammer for the Bootleggers. Now Danger's out of the pack. Artuzo able to get past the Purple Rain defense without that all of the blockers from the Bootleggers coming back to help this go round. But this time, both Danger and Artuzo are in the pack as it stalls on the far straightaway. Once those defensive teams get, you know, have an opportunity to set up, it is just stoppage. So it was that Purple Rain was able to pick up 4 on that jam. Bootleggers with 8. That brings Purple Rain to 165. Bootleggers to 58.
Both teams setting up, seeing a little chit-chat happening as a 3-wall is being formed by both Bootleggers versus Purple Rain. We are both seeing the pivots on the inside of the track, looking to play some O right away. Both jammers hit, and it is Supersonic who is at the top of the pushing out that white wall, trying to find an opening, spins around at the top of the apex and ends up receiving lead. Princess Punch is still stuck, tries to find an opening on the inside line, is denied, tries to find another opening on the inside line, is denied, doing a little juking moves from the inside outside, ends up being stuck in the middle of the Purple Rain's wall. Supersonic just skips right through, not even touched, and does a little mini apex jump, ends up receiving another 4 points. Princess Punch finally is released and is vigorously skating, trying to catch Supersonic. Supersonic is looking for those points, and Princess Punch falls over one of her own blockers, ends up trying to regain control as that blocker ends up getting up and immediately plays O for Princess Punch. Princess Punch still stuck behind, couple of blockers falling while Supersonic is still fighting against a tripod of 4 of 3 white blockers. They end up receiving 4 points as Bootleggers' blocker is assessed a penalty of multi-blocking. We end up having Supersonic coming up for another scoring pass while Princess Punch is looking for a panty pass. The Princess Punch still has panty in hand and has decided, hey, I can do this myself, puts the panty right back on and is looking to try to get some more points. Supersonic is going to keep this game going long, seeing that their blockers are holding back Princess Punch. Princess Punch ends up getting out, and before they are even assessed any points, it is called, comes to its natural conclusion. We end up getting for that jam, Purple Rain, Supersonic, 14 points versus Bootleggers, 4 points from Princess Punch.
I think the Star Pass is a good strategy here if for either team, if you're this defense is just so tough that it's good to have some fresh legs when you can. You see a blocker returning from the penalty box for the Bootleggers. Smurfalicious has got on the star for Bootleggers. Shredder's wearing the star for Purple Rain, and it is Shredder out first, getting everybody released from the penalty box. Full complement of skaters, but that pack is getting stretched out as Smurfalicious exits the pack at turn two. And that was a lot of direction from the bench saying call it, which happens. But still, 1 point on the board. That brings Purple Rain to an even 180. Rootlickers sit at 62.
We are seeing that Purple Rain is one blocker in the box while Bootleggers are having all four blockers. While they have all four blockers, they are looking to use their pivot to try to play some O on the inside line. Before they're even able to engage, a timeout has been called. And the timeout is still going on. Timeout has ended. I'm seeing a couple of refs pointing off to the top of the track. All right, here we are. I think we're about to begin in a little bit. Maybe not. I'll just wait.
So you see in the Twitch chat, you can use your Amazon Prime membership. And if you do so, you'll be notified every time we go live. And if you have that Prime membership, you won't see any ads, which is awesome. So click on the link in the chat if you need more information about linking your account.
Right now, it looks like we're looking for something on the track. There is something that has fallen on the track. And it's official timeout right now.
There's some track repair on the far side, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Saw a couple of skaters looking down, trying to skate along, looking down at the track. I've lost my wedding ring a couple of times, so I no longer wear it when I play derby. So hopefully it's nothing.
That's probably smart.
Yeah. I have been the cause of many timeouts during games because I need to find my ring. Well, just want to give a nice shout out to our officials. Thank you so much, skating, as well as our non-skating officials. We would not be able to have these games happen without your contribution. So once more, thank you very much for taking time coming out and officiating for us. 5 seconds has been called. And we are off. We have Spinderella from Rootlickers in white versus Purple Rain's Danger in purple. Both jammers are trying to find the opening while both walls are refusing to give them an inch. It is Danger who has jumped up to the front of the pack while the tripod is holding fast. Danger is doing a couple of spin moves, trying to trick them out into giving them an opening. They are refusing. And Danger is just using sheer force, pushing them out of play. Danger is only going against a three wall, while Spinderella is stuck behind, trying to find an opening against the tripod. It is Danger who ends up receiving lead at the opening of the apex turn number two. Spinderella is still stuck behind. Danger is looking to receive some points. Spinderella tries to tiptoe on that outside line and inside line and is denied, being forced to go back again. And Danger calls it, receives points, says that's enough. 3 points given to Purple Rain and calls it before Spinderella is even able to get out on the initial pass. We also have It's Shard Core and the Twitch who said, in a game I was reffing yesterday, we had a skater's glasses fly off their face and land 30 feet away.
Oh my gosh.
That was fun.
My goodness. All right, we are in jam number 13. A nice little spin move there. Artuso gets out of the pack as lead, but Supersonic is ahead. So we're going to see this probably get called here. Possibly. No, Artuso is going to take it. Trusting the defense to hang on to Supersonic, but did not. So both jammers have 4 points here. Artuso going to give it another run here. The track advantage there, I was thinking maybe they thought it was safe to run it, but they're going to keep going. So 4 points for both jammers again. 8 apiece so far. Hearing lots of whistles here, seeing bodies go to the penalty box. Supersonic will get driven out of bounds. Now Artuso at the front of the pack and does get out. So there's the pass that Artuso was looking for. 12. There's 12 also for Purple Rain and Supersonic. And so here comes Artuso. Oh, wow. Woo! That was some ballet right there. That was kind of amazing. So Artuso picks up 16 and back into the pack again. Artuso is just going to run it as long as possible. Pick up as many points for the team as can. One blocker tries to take Artuso out, but Artuso is just really good at balancing on those skates. Gets through for another one. That's a 20-point run so far for Artuso. Supersonic now out of the pack as well for a scoring pass. That's 16. Oh, one. A lovely, I'm loving these stylish call-offs. 24 points for the Brutleggers on that run. Purple Rain sits at, has 16 on that run, which makes them at 199. 1 point from 200. We're right at 10 minutes left in the second half.
Excellent job. That was an amazing jam. That was the type of jam that we love seeing in Derby. Both teams are lined up at full blockers, 4-4 call to start. And we are pushing against both those walls. These walls are giving these jammers, they are making them work those legs. They are making them work those edges. They are refusing to give up that easily. It is Shredder for Purple Rain, who's trying to find an opening on the inside, is denied and is drawn back by a Brutlegger blocker with red helmet. Can't really see that number, but shout out to you. We also see Smurfalicious still fighting and grinding against that tripod of Purple Rain, still trying to find an opening. And it is called because Shredder ended up receiving lead. They were to bounce out before Brutlegers and then got swarmed again. We also see on the Twitch, we see from Underground Gallery saying number 23, Flying Frenchie on Brutlegers is number one in my books. Nice shout out.
Nice. Yes. Please tell us anyone that you see, because as you can see from the balcony view, it's a little hard to see the numbers. As we head into jam number 15, it's Danger taking on Spinderella. That's moving a little bit now, but there's that customary block. Defensive tripod just hanging onto the jammer. Spinderella almost through, but does not quite make it. Steps out of bounds, has to be recycled. Danger at the front of the pack looking for a seam. And it looks like that was, oh yeah, that was a call on the jammer. It looked like a legal contact to me, but the referee was facing the opposite direction, so I didn't quite catch that call. But that leaves lead open for Spinderella. Spinderella takes the lead. And now is on a power jam, almost makes it through the pack, but does get a little hip tap there. And that will be a directional for that blocker. The jam will be called, and looks like 2 points were put on the board for the Brutleggers, but they will have a power start for this next jam.
Nice, very nice. So we are having the Brutleggers line up, looking like we are going to be switching between a couple of jammers. We saw one jammer come on the track, but then skate off. We'll see who ends up lining up. And we have a timeout. Oh, an official review.
Oh. Has to be for that jammer penalty, I would think.
Yes. Yes, I agree. That is one major thing that has happened and will affect the game. So I think that that is safe to assume.
Actually, It was called by the bootleggers, right? So that would be maybe they were looking
Oh, it
for
is
a
called by the
penalty that wasn't
bootleggers.
called. So it's not about the jammer after all.
Note to self, actually look at the scoreboard to see who's calling. Yeah, we do have that. But if it was, it would have been the jammer. I would have called an O to try to get my jammer out as well. But yes, Purple Rain does. Yes, Purple Rain still does have their O, but they aren't using it right now.
And if I'm looking at the track correctly, it looks like Purple Rain has got every person they can possibly have in the penalty box right now, a jammer and two blockers.
Yes.
So this is
So
not
this
just
is
a
going to be a
power
power
start for
jam.
bootleggers. Yeah, it's going to be a power jam with a definitive track advantage.
I'm very interested to see if they are going to do O right away off the line, or if it's going to be a delayed O. If they're going to have their jammer hurry up, try to hit, cause a little bit of confusion, and then they come around and swarm. So I'm very interested to see. If it's only two blockers on the track, I personally would say just let your jammer push them out of play. But you know, we all have different styles and strategies. Derby
That's
can be
right.
played in many different ways.
That's true. While we're waiting, I'll tell you about getting back on track. Is your insurance current? Log into the member portal to check your coverage status or go to WFTI.com for more information. WFTDA insurance is valid for 1 year from date purchased. Canadian leagues and skaters go to WFTDICanada.ca for member benefits and information.
Okay, we see the ref end up passing the mic back. They made decision. And looks like we may be starting soon. Yes, and we are going to be starting very soon. Okay, official review was lost by bootleggers. This is a power jam, and bootleggers jammer Artuzio ends up receiving a lead. They fought really fast, and they were able to do some really quick feet movements, nice juking around, and was able to receive lead. They're coming around for a scoring pass, still unopposed. As danger, nope, not danger. The Purple Rain pivot ends up coming out of the penalty box. Artuzo still is able to just fly right through these blockers, ends up receiving 4 points, and it is still a power jam. One more scoring pass if Artuzo is able to receive, while Rootleggers ends up receiving all four of their blockers right on the track. Artuzo only has to go against one, ends up being the swarmed, is stays in on those toe stops, stays in, and ends up receiving 8 points. Artuzo's footwork, amazing. We end up having danger getting out of the penalty box, trying to find an opening so they can hurry up and stop the scoring from Artuso from Rootleggers and White. Danger ends up getting out and is coming around for a scoring pass. Artuso is knocked out on the outside, calls it off before Danger even ends up approaching the pack. Really nice footwork. Really nice footwork
I
from
mean,
Rootleggers Artuso.
Artuzo must like be made of elastic or something. That was insane how many ways the body can bend. But after the intermission, bootleggers really did find a little bit of steam left in their legs here. They're in 98, Purple Rain at 199, but it's been a much broader expanse in terms of point spread. But Supersonic now has got the star on for Purple Rain and is going to stop the hemorrhaging of points here. Princess Punch has got the star on for Bootleggers, is also out of the pack on the initial pass. Both jammers are headed in. Supersonic tries to get through the pack, almost does, but does roll into the infield. We'll call that off. Only picks up 2 points on that pass. It does bring Purple Rain over the 200 point mark at 201. Bootlegger still sits at 98.
Bootleggers, I know they are 2 points away from the century mark. I know that they are going to try to hurry up and get a couple of those points so they can surpass it. We have both jammers lining up, looking to try to find an opening towards the middle and outside line. We see Smurfalicious trying to find that opening on the outside, ends up deciding, no, let me jump into the middle. And it is Shredder who ends up doing a big hop from the outside to the inside to find that opening. And Shredder ends up receiving a lead for Purple Rain and Purple. Smurfalicious in white for Bootleggers is still stuck behind the pack. Shredder is coming around, finding that opening on the outside, finds the opening on the inside, uses the advantage of the fact that the track ends up getting wider at the apex to find those holes, ends up getting out for another scoring pass. They come right through. Shredder is approaching. They are denied an opening from the outside to the inside, still trying to push those Bootlegger blockers up, and Smurfalicious is still stuck behind. Smurfalicious finds an opening, is looking to find some points scoring. There's a couple of whistles happening, a couple of whistles, penalties, as well as calling off the jam had happened. I think a couple of blockers end up going to the penalty box, was not able to see from which team, but now we are starting the next jam. That last jam, it was Purple Rain 7-0.
That's okay. It looks like I heard a lot of whistles also kill, and it looks to me like only one blocker down for the Bootleggers. Supersonic, who has done a great job out on the track today as Jammer gets out of the pack, picks up lead Jammer. Now we'll see a blocker for the Bootleggers head to the penalty box. And oh my goodness, Supersonic from the out to the in gets out of the pack on the initial. Princess Punch takes a little spill, but manages to get right back up. Gets out of that pack for the initial pass. Both jammers are eligible for scoring, but it's Supersonic on the inside, picks up the four, then calls it off. So 8 total for Purple Rain. Bootlegger still sitting at 98. We're 2.5 minutes left in the second half of this game.
We have resumed the short jams when Purple Rain ends up receiving the lead. They are getting the lead, getting a couple of points, and then calling it off right away. So we'll see if that will continue. We have timeout. It's a timeout. Timeout for Purple Rain.
Oh, look, they did get 1 point. So they're sitting at 99, the Bootleggers. That point
snuck
in there.
All right, come on, Bootleggers. Let's go. Let's hit 100. Right, so Purple Rain is just taking a little breather.
Yeah.
All right. No other comments in the Twitch, no other shout outs, but I would like to shout out once more to all the blockers that are doing a phenomenal job. Once more, we want to just recognize you. And if we are able to give out your number, we will. But we see what you're doing. You are holding back those jammers. So great job.
Yes, you're giving those jammers all kinds of trouble.
All right, team timeout has ended. We are waiting for someone to run across the track. Here we go. We are about to start. 5 seconds. We have Danger in Purple for Purple Rain versus Artuso for Bootleggers. They are fighting, and Artuso's trying to find that opening. Holds on to one of their blockers to stay in bounds. It is Purple Rain Danger who's in lead, but Artuso is quickly skating right behind them. Purple Rain's Danger calls it off before Artuso can even receive any points. Let's see. That was exciting.
It was. And I also want to give a shout out to the jerseys that last for those shirt whips, because that was Artuso would have fell out of bounds.
Yes.
So thank you, jerseys, for hanging in there. All right, there is the whistle for jam number 21. Supersonic taking on Smurfalicious. Supersonic with one blocker to beat at the front of the pack does get out as lead jammer for Purple Rain. Smurfalicious. I enjoy watching Smurfalicious. Smurfalicious is a toe stop dancer. So I really enjoy watching Smurfalicious come into the pack and keep going on those toe stops. Meanwhile, Supersonic on the outside finds that lane, picks up four. Supersonic's in on another scoring pass. Meanwhile, Smurfalicious trying to find a seam in that tough tripod we've been talking about it the whole game. The defense is just able to reform over and over. Supersonic picks up an additional four. Rootleggers are able to hold off Supersonic on that pass. Now Smurfalicious is out of the pack on the initial. Supersonic picks up another four. That's 12 so far. And we'll call off that jam there. That brings Purple Rain to 228, Rootleggers to 99. And they do call a timeout to hold off that clock.
Yes, very smart, Rootleggers. You want to get to that century mark. Really good job of calling that off. Let's have one more jam. All right, so we're just going to do the team timeout. We're waiting for it to end, and we're going to have one more jam at least. Purple Rain is at 228 versus Brutelager's 99. And we see on the Twitch, Tom Diana saying, go Shredder. Yes, go Shredder. Shredder is Purple Rain's number 27. But also a shout out to also all of the jammers. Artuzo from Brutelagers, Smurfalicious, Vinderella, Princess Punch, amazing job, as well as Purple Rain, Supersonic, Danger, Shredder. And if there's anyone else I'm missing, I do apologize. We are about to begin. Here we go. 5 seconds has been called. Jam is underway. We have Princess Punch for Brutelagers trying to find the opening, but is given to Shredder. Shredder for Purple Rains. Shredder for Purple Rain coming around on a scoring pass while Princess Punch is still punching right through the, trying to find an opening, speeding it up and making the purple wall end up not coming together. They reform again at the top of the apex, holding back Purple Punch. Brutelagers is denied that last point. Shredder ends up coming up, getting 2 points, and calls it off.
Very smart there on Shredder's behalf, just to say, I understand the period clock's expired. I'm just going to go ahead and call it. We know we've got the comfortable lead. Yeah, very smart move there.
Yeah. Well, that, again, that was a really great game. You're seeing great track awareness, wonderful blocking, O to D, D to O, the tenacity of these jammers having to fight through those walls. It was a good game.
And also, you saw the Brutelagers giving a little dance at the in the last jam there. So a good sportsmanship. That's another thing you can learn from this game as well.
Absolutely.
So there is one more game. Yes, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Kill.
No, go ahead.
I was just going to say there's one more game, so you totally want to come back or stay in this channel so that you can watch the last.
Yes. Well, it's been a pleasure announcing with you. Yeah. I had a great time. And have fun announcing the second game.
Thanks.